Mark Rogers TV and SEC Breakdown, looking at the Ole Miss linebacking unit. We bring in John Luke McCord from the Rebel Walk to help us break it down. And considering the unit loses two of the leaders of the defense over the past couple of years in Denzel Nkemdiche, 212 total tackles during his time in Oxford, and also C.J. Johnson, who they had to move to defensive end a couple of years ago. It's a situation where they've had to go out and bring some people in addition to just straight recruiting from some other campuses, John Luke.
Oh, yeah. Linebackers position, they really had to patch up a little bit this year, no doubt. But they are excited about what they got, bringing in some experience. You know, the transfer, especially the fifth-year transfers, become so popular in college basketball, and Ole Miss is going to be banking on one this year. Rommel Mageo was Oregon State's leading tackler last year, a guy that has a Polynesian, you know, Hawaiian, you know, West Coast connection that Ole Miss's coaching staff is really, you know, coveting at this point. They've started to build that. They have some coaches with connections on the staff there. So that's a guy they're really excited about. They expect him to step in day one and be the starter at middle linebacker. And, of course, DeMarquis Gates returns to play kind of that stinger linebacker, that outside linebacker that'll play off the middle of the field just a little bit and really be relied on to make more plays as far as coverage runs and things like that are concerned. So DeMarquis Gates is perfect for that role. He has the size, the speed combination they like there, and the experience of playing in the system. So he knows what to expect in that role. And to be honest, like we mentioned, the numbers at linebacker, especially after losing a guy like C.J. Johnson and Denzel Nkemdiche you mentioned, are not great. There's not a ton of depth at linebacker, but the good thing for Ole Miss is they run the 4-2-5, and so they're going to play two linebackers most of the time. So you don't need a ton of linebackers in this defensive system, but you need a few. And they have a few other talented guys too. Detric Bing Dukes is the other transfer that's coming in from Iowa Western Community College, originally a signee of Georgia. He was a four-star prospect, I believe, on 247 Sports. He's a guy that they're counting on to be back there, provide some depth. But really in the future, he has 3 years left to be a guy that plays well at the position. Willie Hibbler, just another young guy who's going to provide depth behind DeMarquis Gates, maybe some right there at middle linebacker as well. He's a redshirt freshman. He signed as a tight end, and he's played a little bit of linebacker, enough to know they like him at that position going forward. As far as other guys who are going to provide depth, Tamario Strong is a senior from nearby Batesville, Mississippi, South Panola, a guy that they've waited on for a few years to really contribute on the defensive side of the ball. He's a special teams specialist, really, so great on kickoff and punt return, so valuable. But they're really hoping that he can give them something stopping the run this year at linebacker. So expect him to really get in there, get some snaps. Terry Caldwell is another guy. This is his third year out of junior college nearby Northwest Mississippi Community College. And so they think he's a guy that's going to be able to provide some semblance of what Gates gives them. He's a similar body type and a guy that they hope can help them this year as well at the linebacker spot. The concern here really is that they didn't sign any true prospects at the position in the 2016 class. They signed a few guys that can play linebacker. They might end up moving those guys down to DN. So this year is kind of crucial for some of these young guys that are on the roster to step up. A Ray Smith, who's been around for a few years, who hasn't contributed yet, and especially Hibbler, who's young at the position. So they're really counting on those guys. C.J. Johnson was so valuable last year. He had played DN a few years ago, like you mentioned, but they had to move him to the linebacker spot for depth last year, and he gave them so much his senior year. So it's a position that they're really thin at, but like I mentioned, they don't play a lot on the field at the same time.
All right, one big proven in the linebacking core with DeMarquis Gates, 76 tackles to lead the team coming back this fall. But other than that, a lot of unproven commodities trying to patchwork the Ole Miss linebacking unit against, again, a rugged schedule in the SEC Western Division. John Luke McCord from the Rebel Walk breaking down the linebackers with the Rebels.